So I will be discussing 14th problem. So following is the balance sheet of Bharat Company Limited as on 31st March 2015. So you have all these other assets. Now coming to liability side of balance sheet, you have equity share capital, reserve fund, profit and loss account, 10% debentures, creditors, dividend equalization reserve and tax provision. India Company Limited purchased the business of Bharat Company Limited on the following terms. All the assets except cash and goodwill are taken over. So here they have not taken cash and goodwill. So while transferring the assets, we need not have to transfer cash and even similarly goodwill. But here goodwill, since it is an intangible asset, it does not have realizable value. You transfer goodwill but don't show any realizable value in realization account. All the assets. Okay, this adjustment is over. Next one, 800 shares of rupees 100 each of India Company are issued at an agreed value of 125 per share in full settlement of accounts of creditors. So look into the liability side of balance sheet. Creditors, what is the total value? 1 lakh. So creditors are paid in the form of what? Shares. So how many shares are issued? 800 equity shares. Actually face value is 100 rupees, but it is issued at an agreed value of 125. So 800 into 125, you will get 1 lakh. So this will appear as an opening entries in the books of transferee company. 5 equity shares of rupees 100 each in India Company are issued to equity shareholders at an agreed value of rupees 125. Face value is 100 rupees and agreed value is 125 per share for every 4 shares held in Bharat Company. For every 4 shares means for every 4 shares, how many shares are issued? 5 shares. Therefore, how many equity shares are there? 5,000. So for 5,000, how much? So into 125 rupees. Cash rupees 40 per share held in Bharat Limited is paid to equity shareholders. So how many shares are held? 5,000 into 40 rupees. So here PC is paid in the form of equity shares and cash. 10% debentures are discharged at 20% premium by issue of necessary amount of 12% debentures in India Limited at 4% discount. So this is the new adjustment here. They are issuing at 4% discount. And then we have to pass a new journal entry for this adjustment. So 10% debentures is rupees 2 lakh. So 10% is converted into 12% of debentures of which company? India Company. So they are discharged at 20% premium by issue of necessary amount of 12% debentures in India at 4% discount. This I am going to teach you separately. Close the books of Bharat Company and pass opening entries in the books of India Company under business purchase method. So since they have asked you under business purchase method, so we have to consider only 10% debentures, creditors and tax provision while transferring to the liabilities. So now let us move on to the calculation of PC, which I have already discussed. So this is the calculation of PC. As I told you, PC is paid both in the form of equity shares and cash. So for every 4 shares, 5 shares are issued. So therefore for 5,000, 6,250 shares are issued at 125 per share. So 7,81,250. And in cash, 5,000 into 40, 2 lakhs. The next one you have is discharge of PC. It is discharge in both equity shares and cash. Okay, so 9,81,250. Now let us close the books of transferor company. So first account is realization account. Transfer all the assets. As you have already discussed that goodwill is not taken over. Though it is not taken over, we have to transfer all the assets and then show the realizable value. But the goodwill, since it is an intangible asset, it cannot have a realizable value. So blindly you transfer the goodwill account. So transfer all the assets. Okay. And then similarly transfer the liabilities. As I told you, it is amalgamation in the nature of purchase. The only items to be considered is 10% debentures, tax provision and creditors. And third January, this is for PC due. So per India Company account debtor to realization account, 9,81,250. Balance the account, now you get the profits as 3,21,250, which is transferred to equity shareholders. Moving on to purchasing company account or the transferee company account, India Company account. First you have to show the PC due. So India Company account debtor to realization account, you have 9,81,250. Then PC is received both in the form of shares and cash. So by equity shares is India Company, 7,81,250, by cash 2 lakh. Come to equity shareholders account. First you have to show the amount due. So equity share capital account, by reserve fund, by profit and loss account, by dividend equalization reserve account. So all these are the four items which you will get it on the liability side of balance sheet. Then you have final settlement made to equity shareholders. Equity shareholders account debtor to equity shares in India Company Limited account 7,81,250. Then you have realization profit, that is 3,21,250. Balance the account. So 2,40,000 should be transferred to which account? Cash or bank account. Actually, in cash we have to pay 2 lakh rupees, but the amount available here is 2,40,000. We'll move on to bank account. So write the opening balance as it is given in the balance sheet, and then in the equity shareholders account, balancing figure that you got is 2,40,000. So bank account debtor to India Company account is rupees 2 lakh. So with this, we'll complete the balance sheet. That is bank account. Next one you have is equity shares in India Company account. So equity shareholders account debtor to equity shares, that is PC paid, so 7,81,250. So then equity shares in India Company, this is PC received, so 7,81,250. So you balance the account, the account will be tallied. Moving on to the opening entries. So you have PC due, business purchase account debtor to liquidator of Bharat Company Limited account. Then for the PC payment, so PC is paid in the form of shares and cash. So liquidator of Bharat Company account debtor to equity share capital 100 rupees, premium is rupees 25. You can split it up, and to bank account 2 lakh. Now for the incorporation of assets and liabilities, you have building, machinery, all the assets are transferred. So assets account debtor to concerned, liabilities taken over. Since it is an amalgamation in the nature of purchase, so the balancing figure will be transferred either to goodwill account or capital reserve account. So now this is important adjustment here. So as I told you, we'll move on to the adjustment. Debenture adjustment. 10% debentures are discharged at 20% premium. What is the premium? 20% by issue of necessary amount of 12% debentures in India Limited at 4% discount. So the general entry will be like this. 10% debentures of Bharat Company Limited account is rupees 2,40,000. So how did you get 2,40,000? It is a premium. So how much is the value of debentures? 2 lakh. How much is the premium? 20%. Calculate 20% on 2 lakh. You will get 2,40,000. So 2,40,000. Discount on issue of debentures account. So it is a loss. So 2,40,000. On this 2,40,000, how much is the discount? 4 rupees. So divided by 96. How did you get 96? 100 minus 4. That is 96. So how much is the discount? 10,000. If you have to prepare balance sheet, this will be shown as a miscellaneous expenditure on the asset side of balance sheet. So 2 12% debentures account is rupees how much? 2,50,000. So here 10% debentures of Bharat Company account, how much you are supposed to write? 2,40,000. That is premium. Okay, to creditors account, to business purchase account 9,81,250. Next, we'll move on to the last general entry, payment made to the creditors. So creditors are paid in the form of shares. So creditors account debtor to share capital, how much? How many shares? As already discussed in the adjustment, 800 into 100 and 800 into 25 share premium. Separately, you can show. So 80,000 and 20,000. So with this, we'll complete this 14th problem.